Hello, my beautiful art community. Thank you so much for tuning into my channel today. Today I'm going to be doing something a little bit different than what I usually do. This might be the part where you ask me, Candace, what is it that you actually normally do? And honey, I couldn't answer that question for you. However, I can kind of tell you what we're going to be doing today. We're basically going to be staying fairly monochromatic. And I guess in some situations on the composition, it is a limited palette because I do use slightly a little bit of yellow, but that's further in conversation in the video. However, largely in the composition, I'm going to be staying monochromatic. I am not going to be using any black. However, I will just be staying with violet and white. I'm going to be using my husband, Teimour, as a reference photo for this. I'm going to be using him as my model for this composition that I'm going to be showing you. I actually think that he is an excellent model for this, and I will show you why. So without further ado, let's get this party started.
Here's the reference photo that I'm going to be using for this painting. I'd say that this is the most important part of the painting because this is the part where we are going to be mapping out all of those proportions. I'm just going to be doing a general gesture of the shape that I'm observing at this moment. So yeah, I am just trying to get that overall shape of his head. And so I've gotten the rest of the face down. And this part, I am just making some further decisions, and I'm trying to cut the parts that I don't see that are matching what's in the reference photo. But overall, I'm just trying to get that big idea. I think a common misconception about art is that everything's about the detail. And it's really not, actually. And so here I have made my decision on what works and what doesn't work. And so from there, I just added the variations in the skin tone among the face. And so here I am just deepening those values in order to really draw the buildup to the lighter values within the face. Because I'm really trying to achieve some serious drama here. I'm trying to really show that there is light being cast on his face. And I'm going into this painting with the idea of shapes. I'm thinking of them as shapes, value shapes. I'm not necessarily looking at it as an eye, a nose, or some lips, but I'm just thinking of it as just simple shapes that I'm finding. And I am sort of going about this in a choppy manner. I'm just finding those values and matching them accordingly to however I feel about the composition. It's really about how you feel. So I know that I said that I thought that he was a good model. And the reason why I say that is because, to me, he has a interesting face, and I find that the shape in his face is particularly interesting. I found inspiration from him because of the shadow that is casted underneath his eyes. There's actually a very heavy shadow. And so here I just sectioned off where I knew most of the darker values were going to be. It makes sense because when you're going back and forth between brushes, between the lighter paints and the darker paints, it can sometimes get really messy. So you gotta be careful about that. I am definitely the worst person when it comes to being messy. I constantly have to remind myself to clean my brush and clean the palette. And I especially say this with more specifically oil paints. I think that they can get much more messy. But another tip that will help is just to mix with a palette knife. I am actually going between, and I'm just mixing my paints as well. I try to do this before I start my painting as well, as I'll just spend time mixing on the palette with my palette knife in order to get that those values that I'm going to be using within the painting. It just saves a lot of time that way as well. And so here I know that I pretty much have it to where I want it to be, but I still know that there's a little bit more room to push the composition. So here's the final painting. I am really happy with how this turned out. I also just decided to give it another go, give it another shot. You know, the worst thing that I could do was just produce a terrible painting, and so why not, right? But I actually ended up liking this painting more. I actually kind of wish I made a video on this painting instead, but you can't have everything, can you? And I just want to give you a big, big, big thank you for taking the time to stick on my channel, watch my video, support me. You have no idea how much I appreciate you. So go on ahead and help a sister out and hit that like and subscribe button, because I know that you want to.
It is easier to just show you in I can't even speak. Why does this happen every time that I try to make a video? And so without further ado, let's get this party started. I'm trying to contemplate and concentrate on where to take your ass. I think I got a. So without further ado, let's get this party started. No, that's not the one. That is not the money shot. This is the money shot. So without further ado, let's get this party started.